Hi guys, this is Canon. Welcome you all to my channel, Canon's School of ASP.NET. Today I am going to show you how to create a project using Entity Framework Core and using database first approach. So guys, let's go to the project. Thank you. At first, we open SQL Server Management Studio. Okay, we connect with Windows Authentication. Now we have to create database. We have this database. We will create a ASP.NET core project using database first approach. So at first we have to create a database. So we open a query file that is createable. We will create a database named inventory. Then using this database, we will create two tables. One table name is product and other table name is stock. Product table has the field name product ID, integer type, not null, identity 101,1 means it will start from 101 and increment with 1. Then product name, character type, product type, it is also character type, product manufacturer, it's also character type, and constraint is product ID, primary key, product ID. Constant name is PK, product ID, and product ID, this value, this at column will be treated as a primary key. Now for stock table, stock ID is integer type and not null. Identity, it will start from 2001 and it will be incremented by 1. Then product ID, then product quantity, product price, stock date, and constraint, two constraints here, one for primary key, stock ID is a primary key, and another for foreign key. Here foreign key is product ID reference. Product table, product ID on grid cascade. That means if we delete the product table, then the relation will be, this constraint will be deleted. Okay, now run this query and create database and table. Command successfully completed. That means database and tables has been created successfully. Now check, there is no database name inventory. Now refresh this and check now. Okay, there is a database named inventory. And now check the table names. Okay, product and stock, this two table has been created. Okay, now we will start Visual Studio 2017. Create a new project. Okay, .NET Core, then ASP.NET Core Web Application, Okay, put a name. Name maybe a stock, a product, that, and a stock DB first. DB first, BDB first. Okay. Now, from this, choose web application model view controller and change authentication. Choose no authentication and okay. 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 Project has been created. It will appear in Solution Explorer. Okay, appeared. Now we check. We have no model for product and stock. Okay, we have no model for product and stock, and no DB context, and we have no controller. It is taking time for first time users. Okay, controller, we have no controller, only hop controller, because when project created, a home controller also has been created. Now we have to create model from our database. Now from tools, Nuget package manager, then package manager console, and we have to run a command to create model. We open the command. This is a command. Okay, copy and paste. Okay, this is our command, scaffold db context. That means it will create our models and also we have to copy the connection string, copy and paste. App settings, okay, we have to copy this and okay, this is our connection string, our server name and database name inventory. It will be put here in app setting .json file. We have to put connection string top of the content of this file. Okay, now run this scaffold db context, and this is our connection string, desktop SQL server, then database name, then that is put here, also put here. Then first connection string, here connection string, then Microsoft.EntityFramework.SQLServer, and output directory. Okay, we will small it to 5%. Yes, our output directory should be model, so that model file will be created in models folder. Now run this code, run this escape hold command. Okay. It will take a little bit time and we will see model will be changed, and here three file will be created, one for product, one for stock, and another for DB context. DB context contain all the information of database that we will access database through this DB context. We will use this DB context as database. So we will explore all object of this database from this DB context. Okay, here inventory context has been created. Now we have to change startup. Now it can be closed. Services, we have to add here services dot add db context. For this we have to use here using product dot models and Microsoft dot entity framework core. Okay, now dot add db context. Services. Dot add db context inventory context is our context now. Okay, now for test we run this. If any build error, build succeeded, so we have no build error. If we have any build error, then we cannot create model using, cannot create controller using this model. So at first we have to remove all build error. Okay, project is running. Okay, project has been run successfully without any error. Okay, now we stop it and create our controller. Okay, first at controller we should choose MVC controller with views using entity framework. Now click add. Now we have to choose model class. Model class. Okay, we should check the models. These are product models. Here we just remove this. We need not this. we have public integer product ID, stream product name, product type, product manufacturer, and there is a stock. This is for navigation stock. Stock is a class. We have create a stock type collection here. Now stock. We have stock ID, product ID, product quantity. As it is database table, we have this type in our database table, and based on this database table, model has been created. Now we can create our controller. Now to add controller, then MVC controller with views using entity framework, and then for first we should choose model class as product, then DB context is inventory context, generate views. With this controller, views will be created. Okay, now click add. Okay, our mode controller has been created. So as well as controller, our views also has been created. For product, we have create, delete, details, edit, and index. These five views. Okay, we first check our controller. Here, this is private only inventory control. We created here a context, inventory context, object name underscore context. Then we have created a constructor, products controller, constructor, and pass inventory context, object name context. Then we have assigned this context to this div context, and now we have these action methods. As index, it is asynchronous code, so asynchronous code should be used with await, and for normal MVC we just use dot to list, and here we should have used to list async. This is the difference with normal MVC code and ASP.NET MVC code. So if we normally write our code, then we will write normal MVC code, but if we create code automatically, then MVC.NET code will create asynchronous code. All action method is asynchronous code. Now here product details, here is a condition, and we have product from context is our database object, and product is a table of this object. So this small product contain the table product, and here we show all the element of this table here, and here is create action method. Here just we return this view. Here, post action method, after getting the information from this action method, here we will save it from database. Here we will insert the record here and then save it. That means commit it and then return it to index method. And finally, we return product object to view. Here edit action method and one other action method is also here. Five action method and five views will be created. Okay, now run this project. Okay, project has been run. Now we check product. Okay, it has been came. We have product name, product type, product manufacturer 3. And if we create it, then we have 3 data type or 3 column, but we check our code that our model has 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 4 column, but product ID will also created automatically. Just we have to input these 3 column. Now from browser, we just input product name. Name should be mango. Product type fruits. Manufacturer Rashahi. Others. Okay, just create. Okay, one record has been created. Now create another record. It banana product type also fruits. Then manufacturer session. Brothers. Okay, now product name range, product type is crops. Parisa Brothers. Create. We have created 3 records. Now we can edit it. Okay. Mango should be changed as orange. It's also fruits. Okay, we can save. Then mango change to orange, and we can delete this. Delete. Okay, this has been deleted. Now we create another record. X product type x for tree. Okay, now create. Now we just check. We have been checked that all these three action has been working. Okay, now we just end the project and create another action, another controller, and controller MVC, then stock and add. Okay, the stock has been created. Similarly, here and context class, it is its object. Then we have a constructor. This is mandatory for all controller. We have to create a context object, then we have to create a constructor. It is mandatory. Then the action methods will be working. Similarly, our product controller, this stock controller, has been created with 5 views. Here stock has 5 views. Here has 5 action methods. Okay, now we just run again the project and check the stop. Okay, we will type here stocks. Okay, stocks here, product quantity, product price, stock date, and product. Here we just, if we create it, then here product quantity, here is 3 product, here shows product ID, but for navigation properties, here comes the manufacturer name. But it is linked with its product ID. If we click this, then it will be navigate with its product ID. And we just choose okay is then product quantity, that's 100, product price, $105, stock, date, dash. Okay, this one. Now create. Okay, this record has been created. Okay, now we create another record for this date. 50, price 35, stock date 20, okay. stock date. Okay. Okay. Because it is month first, then date, then year. Now, for Dhaka Brothers, okay, quantity 60, price 20, stock date 10 and 2017. Okay, great. Okay, we have three record. Now we can change this view. Changing this code here, we should change index method. Product. We can use here model dot. Product ID, and here also product and product ID. Okay, now refresh it. Okay, we have got product ID. But this field escape from the product table. This is a stock controller, but we have get this IDs, but when we input this, we have never input this product ID, but we have got here this product ID because it is navigated from product. So this is how to show how to use database first approach to create a project using Entity Framework Core. So guys, thank you all to watch my videos, and I am requesting all to subscribe my channel ASP.NET Canon School of ASP.NET, and keep me in your task. Thank you.